They were now trying to find out other souls. Kaya natakot yung mga tao because of what Jesus did. Because before they knew that legion was attached lang sa isang tao. But now he was roaming around in the atmosphere looking for anybody to be open. Kaya pinalayas si Jesus. Okay? So demons prefer souls.
Dr. Nati, last question. Ano yung tatanungin niyo?
Another encounter that priest to invite me one time, and then he was not there, and then I was made to sleep in a place, and then I felt strange. I mean, I felt very weak. I couldn't sleep, and then I was very tired, and then I experienced that somebody gave me a blanket. So when I woke up 1 o'clock in the morning, I said thank you to the catechists who were around me. But nobody wanted to sleep with me. So I said, why? The bed is very big. Why don't you want to sleep with me? And then I said, I feel very weak. I don't know if I feel like this. And then they reported it to the priest who was somewhere. And then they said, Mom, because maybe somebody is there. I said, oh. And then I discovered later on, Father, that there was a skull that was wrapped by the priest and placed by my foot, not under the bed. And then, so I said, you call the priest. And then I confronted the priest, why are you keeping the skull? The skull does not belong here. It belongs to another world. And then he told me, Father, because the skull helps me in exorcising, sabi niya. Kasi one time daw, nag-exorcise daw siya, Father. Tapos yung ina-exorcise niya, mukha ng mother niya. So it was a temptation for him to stop exorcising. Kasi nga, mukha ng mother niya. Pero sabi daw nung skull sa kanya, whisper daw sa kanya, that's not your mother, that's not your mother. So is that true? Anyway, he's dead already, so...
Okay. Well, muna sa lahat, demons are deceivers, okay? So we have a very careful the ministry that we always check. Lahat ng ginagawa namin ay ayon sa church tradition, church ministerio, ay really based on church teachings of the Bible. Right? We make sure that our foundation is always correct. Right? Because even in the Roman ritual of exorcism, there is a reminder there to exorcists to be very careful because the demons can insert some form of occult activity that may seem effective so that the priest starts to bring in the occult into his ministry, and then later on, we believe them that he becomes open to demonic attacks kasi nagkakaroon siya ng opening. Spirits start to come in through the opening. Because when you start, because there are certain priests, no, na hindi masyado, they are not so aware of the ministry, or they're not really that learned about the ministry, therefore, may hinahalo sila. No? For example, they use, I remember there was nga this priest na who used to exercise, pero sometimes ginagamit niya yung sa manok, yung parang feather ng manok. No? Pinapalo niya, ano, nakita niya isang exorcist siya, nakikwento sa akin, no? Or I think it was the, yung sa stingray, yung pinaka, no, yung pagi, no? So, kaya sumisigaw yung tao, kaya tumingin yung isang exorcist, no? Nagulat siya, kasi pinapalo niya, kaya sumisigaw talaga yung tao, no? Because, masakit eh, di ba? So, this is, kaya in the Roman ritual, we're very, very careful that nothing occult enters into the picture. Because once it occurs, once pumasok, the devil will try to show that it's first effective. Ganun yung mga occult activities, parang pag ginawa mo itong ritual, may mangyayari. So that we will little enter into remove ourselves from the proper means given to us by the Lord and start to enter the occult. Then doon na papasok, makukontaminate yung ministry mo, you become less effective, open to retaliation. Okay, so una muna sa lahat, yung mother na nakita niyo mukha, no soul possesses a person. Okay? A soul who is dead, who is in purgatory, heaven or hell, do not possess. Only evil spirits possess people. Okay? So that's a teaching of the church. So, hindi pwede na, for example, na sinaniban siya ng neosalisal or ng isang a person, okay? Or yung kanyang grandmother, okay? Because the souls are really judged. They cannot leave where they are, the judgment place that they are placed into. So that's not the grandmother, that's a deception, okay? And therefore, that's the tinuloy niya exorcism. Now, mukhang psychic ang pari na to because he could hear voices. Usually, unless you are a mystic, you're in the mystical state of prayer, that's the only time the Lord may speak to you through locutions or through visions. But if you're not yet into the mystical state of prayer, no, yung sinasabi si Teresa Avila, no, the mystical life, okay, then the Lord will only inspire you with inspiration. So pag narinig siya ng boses, that means makabawas yung third eye niya, and it's not the skull who is speaking to him, to the person, because the soul is not anymore in the skull, okay, nor the soul is anymore present around, it's an evil spirit, making him rely on the skull, okay? So doon napapasok yung sinasabi natin contamination. Later on, magulat siya, bakit hindi na effective. Or the skull, if he starts to rely on the skull, later on, sasabihin ng skull, itong gawin mo. Okay? And then later on, he's already into the cult. Wala na siya sa ministry of exorcism. He's not using already the ministry given to us by Christ.
Nakakailang exorcism ka sa isang linggo?
Well, we have actually, like for example, every week, we have around 6 cases of possession yon. So usually, as much as possible, we try to get to a day, ganun. But usually, I make a day in between. Kasi especially yung mga, medyo lumalala yung mga cases, so we get harassed, also retaliated, also we have a team. So usually, I make a day in between, because or else, when you're dreaming, you can burn out there. Especially, there are demons who, remember, we're fighting a spiritual war. Parang si Pablo si John Revealing, no? They get oppressed. Kami rin get oppressed, no? And especially kapag mabigat yung mga cases, like mga satanista na buwabalik sa simbahan, they practice cannibalism and human sacrifice, no? So, when we try to bring them out, you see the spirits attack us at night, no? Especially sa ako, no? So, although I don't get dysfunctional, I still get, I also get tired pa rin. So depending rin sa case eh, yung mga medyo mabibigat na kaso, I handle it, so medyo extreme.
May napoposess ba mong pare?
Ay, marami!
Well, as of now, seminarista ka lang, no? Usually...
I'm
not saying anything, kasi no? Actually, the most is oppression. Okay, like, we're taking down exorcists from different dioceses. Usually, they experience male, but they're good, they feel a lot of oppression. Again, we're training in Bolo, no? In Calocan, no leeches. But I've never yet encountered a priest in a process. Usually, yun ang mga... Well, marami mother, as I mentioned. Pass, no? She's in charge of the sisters. They come to us usually. Okay, she has around 70 plus cases of sisters that are here at the moment. And around 30% are actually possessed. Many of them can come from pagan backgrounds, yung mga, especially marami mga activities.
That's good thing. Now I know that exorcism is a ministry. So it's not a joke to exercise exorcism. For us, priests, I'm not a priest. For the priest, for the teachers or catechists, are there requirements? For example, properly disposed, one prayer, or spiritually prepared. Otherwise, basta may drawback sa amin.
Basically, the state of grace. And also, you don't have to use the proper sacramentals, and you're protected now with the sacramentals and your devotion to your guardian angel and to Mama Mary. And you don't only pray prayers for blessing, but also for protection, and also prayers to the guardian angel for protection. And you use regularly, usually, your prayers to liberation, maybe once a week, no? Casting out spirits on your own. Then, kung may in a case, that's the will of God, you will be protected. Yeah, pag may mga cases na bigat, inakos kayo, then remember that if the Lord allowed that to happen, that means you have enough spiritual grace to expel the spirit or to assist the person. Okay? And that's why if ever that happens, don't be afraid. Remember, you have all that is necessary or else the Lord will not have sent that person to you. Okay?
It's 7 o'clock. Yung may tanong, labitan na lang si Father. Aalis na raw siya. Sana yung sa ko dyan. Ang ex-toto dyan, mahal nila ka lang po. Ganda na lang ang powers ko eh. Kung tayo sa mga superiora, offered to you handouts. One is the letter to the bishop with regards to the participation for the First Holy Communion for diocese from the Archdiocese of Cebu. Please get one copy, all right? Second is the copy of the evaluation form. I'm giving it to you now because I'd like you to fill that in, especially with suggested topics and venue for next year's AMCM. Right? Suggested topics, venue for next year's AMCM. Please get a copy. But don't pass them tonight kasi we still have two programs for discussion tomorrow. Namely, the instrument of certification of catechetical centers under ACRE, Father William and Dr. Pilar, and the UCAT launching under Bishop Bobet Malyari, our incoming chairman of EDSHEF. Okay, kindly get a copy, please. And then, it's okay with you, a little bit of sacrifice. Dinner could be at 7:30. We will go to the chapel for exorcism.